Victory today is mine. I told Satan, get behind. Victory today is mine. Oh, hey, hey, what's going on, YouTube? Yeah, this video is on a time of rejoicing, and you know what time it is, so let's get it.
Come on! Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me?
And they can't defeat me, that's the whole thing.
Right.
Cause heaven's above me and God reigns.
Reign,
these truths I have to proclaim, make plain, so you could understand what it is I lay claim to.
Come on.
What I've gone through.
Now, you ever had that time where you just praising God and you rejoicing, and then you got people watching you, and you're like, why are you watching me praise? Because I know what God has done for me, and I don't know what he's done for you, but I know what he's done for me, and I just love to praise him. Hey, so this is, I don't preach like that. You know that, right? Okay, so this is part three of our topic on time, and this is a time of rejoicing. And you all know one of my favorite verses, and I write it on my heart, and I tell people all the time, and I put it in my music. And it's Psalms 37 and 4, and it says, delight yourself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart, of thine heart. And one of the things that people fail to realize is we hear the saying all the time that time flies when you're having fun. Well, you know that came from the Bible, obviously not in those words, because Satan doesn't want you studying the Bible, because if you did, then you know how to defeat him and his little demons. So it does mention that, and you know how you can be somewhere, and I've used this before. For those of you that are in the clubs that may be watching this video or may have watched this video or these videos, and you say to yourself, well, time flies. I got in the club at 11. It doesn't close until 5. That was back when I was in Miami. And it seems like only an hour passed, but you were in there for that extensive period of time, because at the time, that is what made you happy. So you did not know that time was passing by. Well, it changed when I became a Christian. I got with my saints, my other prophets, my other evangelists, some apostles, and we would just sit down and we would talk, and we would come after work, and it seemed like we would be tired, and we would get together after work, and we would sit around the table at the evangelist's house, and we would start talking about the Word of God and about things going on in the church, and we would come together like 7 or 8, and we wouldn't leave until like 3 or 4 in the morning, because we would forget that time was flying. And then some of us would leave, and then some of us would stay. We would be talking about the Word, and then next thing we know, we look at the watch, and it's like 5 o'clock in the morning. Okay, time to get home, go to sleep. But it's the same thing. When the thing that's in your heart causes you to rejoice, you don't realize that time is passing, right? So let's get into the scripture. It is obviously from Solomon, King Solomon, the wisest man to walk the earth next to Jesus. It says in Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verses 18 through 20, behold that which I have seen. It is good and comely for one to eat and to drink and to enjoy the good of all his labor that he taketh under the sun all the days of his life, which God giveth him, for it is his portion, right? Every man also to whom God hath given riches and wealth and hath given him power to eat thereof, and to take his portion and to rejoice in his labor, this is the gift of God. Notice something if you go back in verse 19 where it says, every man to whom God hath given riches and wealth, right? And hath given him power to eat thereof and to take his portion and to rejoice in his labor. It is the gift of God. So as I explained to you all before, money with a whole bunch of health issues means nothing. So Solomon had to clarify for some people, and this is by revelation so you understand it. Solomon had to say, every person that God has given riches as wealth, and then he's given them the power to eat. You understand? Because we take eating for granted, but it's something that God doesn't have to allow us to do, right? There are a ton of rich people that cannot feed themselves. God forbid that happens to us as saints. But I want to clarify that, because I've been teaching you all about that for quite a while now. So Solomon said, they have the riches of wealth, and God has given them the power to eat thereof. See, some people have the riches and wealth and they can't feed themselves. They can't clothe themselves. They can't wash their own bodies. They cannot brush their own teeth. So all the money in the world, I'm sure they would give it up to be able to have the ability or the power, as Solomon said, to do those things. Now, verse 20 is the key verse. It says, "For he shall not much remember the days of his life, because God answereth him in the joys of his heart." So what does that mean? That means time flies when you're having fun. Solomon said in verse 20, "He shall not much remember the days of his life, because God answereth him in the joys of his heart." See, so when you're rejoicing in what God has allowed you to accomplish or allowed you to do, your days are going to fly. And you're going to look back and say, "I don't know where the time went, but I know that all these memories are great memories because God has answered you in the joy of your heart." So, ladies and gentlemen, this is a time of rejoicing. You could think about the story when King David went and brought the Ark of the Covenant back, right? In 2 Samuel chapter 6, verses 12 through 16. And it was told King David, saying, "The Lord hath blessed the house of Obed-Edom and all that pertaineth unto him because of the ark of God." So David went and brought the ark of God from the house of Obed-Edom into the city of David with gladness, rejoicing. You understand what gladness is, right? Right. "And it was so that when they that bear the ark of the Lord had gone six paces, he sacrificed oxen and fatlings." This is Old Testament. This is what David did, right? "And David danced before the Lord with all his might. And David was girded with a linen ephod. So David and all the house of Israel brought up the ark with shouting and with the sound of the trumpet. And as the ark of the Lord came into the city of David, Mi-chal, Saul's daughter, looked through a window and saw King David leaping and dancing before the Lord, and she despised him in her heart." Now, if you continue to read, it talks about how Mi-chal got upset, right? Because it says that David had danced with all his might and somewhat uncovered himself, or at least that's what she said. And so David said, "You know what? I'll become even more undignified than this." I know some of y'all know that godly Christian song. Actually, David said, "I will be more vile than this, you know, in the eyes of the Lord." Let me go ahead and read it to you. 2 Samuel chapter 6, verse 20. "Then David returned to bless his household, and Michal, the daughter of Saul, came out to meet David and said, 'How glorious was the king of Israel today, who uncovered himself today in the eyes of the handmaids of his servants, and as one of the vain fellows shamelessly uncovered himself.' And David said unto Michal, 'It was before the Lord, which chose me before thy father and before all his house to appoint me ruler over all the people of the Lord, over Israel. Therefore will I play before the Lord, and I will yet be more vile than thus, and will abase myself in my own sight, and of the maidservants which thou hast spoken of them shall I be had in honor.'" Right. And then because the wife of David was foolish at the time, David said, therefore, Michal, the daughter of Saul, had no child until the day of her death. That means David was like, "I don't even want to touch you because you don't understand that God is king. And it wasn't before the people I was doing it. It was before God." The Bible says that he danced so hard that he danced up out of his clothes or uncovered himself. That was a time of rejoicing when God sent Israel out to battle, and God said, "You don't have to do anything but praise me, and I'm going to take care of your enemies for you." And as they began to praise and to worship, and the singers went first, the Bible says, and as they began to praise and to worship, it says that their enemies, the two different groups of armies started killing each other. And once they killed each other, the army that was left started killing off one another. And that was just all from praising God, because Satan gets confused. How could you praise God when you know that you're going through something? Hey, when you learn to do what King David said in Psalm chapter 34, verse 1, "I will bless the Lord at all time, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth," Satan will get confused. I'm throwing everything at you, including the kitchen sink, dropping a piano from the roof, trying to get it to fall on you, and you will not stop praising God. Something must be wrong with you. That's what Satan is thinking. But what God is thinking is something must be right with you. And I know that I need to keep pouring out a blessing on you. So you don't stop praising and worshiping God because you're going through something. Because if you do, then that means your love for God is conditional. We don't want conditional love. We want that unconditional love. We want God to know that regardless of what goes on, I'm going to bless your name. ladies and gentlemen. So the time of rejoicing is now. Some of you have struggled for a long time and you kept your heart right before God and God was doing all these things for you. You didn't recognize it, but now that you recognize it, now that you realize God has blessed me, and even though I don't have everything I want, God has given me everything I need. Even though I don't have all the money in the world, which you don't necessarily need anyway, because some of you wouldn't know what to do with it. But even though I don't have all the money in the world, I have the power to eat. You understand? I have my fingers and my toes. I can see. I can hear. I can sing. I can dance. I can walk. I can do the things that I should be able to do. And even for the people that don't have those things, you may be listening to this video, I want you to understand something. There is miracle working power in God. God can send someone to pray for you, to heal you. The Bible says that Jesus healed cities. Jesus told us in John 14 and 12, verily, verily, I say unto you, the works that I do shall you do also, and greater works than these shall you do, because I go unto my Father. So Jesus told us the things that I do, you could do, and you could do greater. Y'all ain't getting me. I wish y'all were with me today. Are you here right now? Are you listening to what I'm telling you? Jesus said, the works that I do shall you do also, and greater works than these. So if Jesus went about and healed cities of people, we can do it. That in and of itself right there should make you want to rejoice, especially when you get to know God on an intimate level, right? And you get to know God on that level and you start seeing God do things, and I'm talking from experience, and you a distance away and God start manifesting his glory on somebody. It's a wonderful thing. Ladies and gentlemen, a time of rejoicing. I don't care what you're going through. When you know Jesus on a real level, and that's what I want you all to do, and that's why I do these videos. I want you to know Jesus on a real level, on an intimate level, deeply. And I want Jesus to be able to say, when you get to heaven or you stand before judgment, I want Jesus to be able to say, well done, thy good and faithful servant, because he knows you. You're in his heart and he's in yours. Ladies and gentlemen, I love you all. I will see you all again soon. I love you all. I will see you all again soon. This is a time of rejoicing. God has been good to you. God is doing some wonderful things. Don't you stop. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. Hallelujah.
Come on. Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me?
And they can't defeat me, that's the whole thing.
Right.
Cause heaven's above me and God reigns.
Reign,
these truths I have to proclaim, make plain, so you could understand what it is I lay claim to.
Come on.
What I've gone through. To